In our special series, Art Matters, we look at a highly acclaimed exhibition, a two-year project in which artists from Sri Lanka and India travel together to two famous pilgrimage sites, one in India, one in Sri Lanka.
Varanasi and Anuradhapura in Sri Lanka, two holy cities that become part of an artistic journey for six Indians and five Sri Lankan artists.
The whole idea was an interaction between two countries, two cultures, and there are many shared histories. And Southeast Asia definitely has very commonalities amongst many countries. My whole purpose was to do a very serious research-based show. And I think we've been quite successful in it.
In a region where the sacred is never far from the political, not surprisingly, many of the artists responded to this intersection, like Indian photographer Ram Rahman.
Looking at these two sites, which are steeped in religious traditions and are focus of very intense religious pilgrimage and belief, it was a real struggle for me to, you know, to conceive a work which connected these two cities. That was just chance that I had these five monks in this photograph, because the first sermon that he gave was to five companions. And the texts that I have used in this whole piece are either ancient texts from the Buddhist tradition, or contemporary texts, which are newspaper texts. And I followed through to very recent events in India, which is the suicide of the Dalit scholar and student, PhD student at Hyderabad University, Rohit Vemula. And you see them carrying out the painting of Ambedkar. So Ambedkar is a modern figure in India who called for the Dalits to convert to Buddhism.
Sri Lankan artist Pala Pothupithiye explored how the same symbols of Buddhism become tools of asserting state power in his country.
Here I'm especially focusing the stupa. That stupa is very invisible inside. And this stupa I call is like the victory domes. The Buddhism has come to Sri Lanka as a institutionalized Buddhism. So which is so much engaged with the power, politics, and that all the boundaries between other religions.
The yellow of Buddhism sees politics much like the saffron of India.
I was most strangely fascinated by the fact that you always assign calm and peace with Buddhism as a religion, and it becomes an aggressive religion, and outcomes are aggressive in Sri Lanka. So I think the larger picture is how religion becomes aggressive. And I think it's not just in our country. I think it's happening at different levels.
And so the reclaiming becomes.
So the reclaiming becomes for me very difficult. For example, I really want to reclaim color orange, I just don't want to give it up.
And that need to reclaim a personal meditative equation with the sacred led to Manisha Parekh's work, where even the process of creating the art became part of a personal assertion.
I thought of making these home shrines, and it's like the way we adorn a deity, and the kind of process we take on in terms of adornment, where we are kind of bathing it, clothing it, then it happens at different stages and times of the day.
A tale of two cities' strength lies in the complex material each artist offers in their exploration of the history, spirituality and politics of a pilgrimage site. With Rakesh Solanki and Sumi Deogam, Radhika Bordia for NDTV.